heart beat. Just commence your feet to skate. Pick up your arms and make them shake. Baby, if you think you're shy, do me a favor, honey, go someplace and hide.
Shout out Rico.
This thing ain't even using
shout
the Wi-Fi,
out boys.
Man.
Shout out Milk.
Maybe it is. Who knows?
They're Rico, listening. Rico, get your ass out here.
They're listening, man. So, top three Drake albums.
I honestly, I couldn't tell you off the top of my head what all of them the names are.
So we got Nothing Was the Same. Then we got Views, and we got Scorpion. Then we got a few things in between. If you're reading this, it's too late. Thank me later. So Far Gone. Fucking.
If you're reading this, it's too late. That's a good one.
More Life.
More Life. That was. I think More Life was a good one. That one.
Young Money, nigga. Young Money, Cash Money. That whole album was dope.
Oh yeah. We are Young Money. Yeah. Lil Twist is fire, man. He's got a song on there. That shit was fire. Well, you said if you're reading this, it's too late.
Yeah, that I like. Six Man, that's probably my favorite track off that.
Yeah. Like Lou Will.
What's the one? He just did. I think it's off of Scorpion. No, it wasn't Scorpion. It was More Life, I believe. With Murder Beats.
Oh, the Nice for What?
No. Fuck, I forget what. I'm gonna have to look it up.
Yeah, everybody gotta wear these shades, man. This shit's, yeah.
What were we talking? Something about favorite Drake.
I
can't hear you. Yeah. No Long Talk. That's a No Long Talk.
Did Murder do that?
Quintessential in the motor tech slam. Yeah.
Did he?
Yeah. That's probably the best song, in my opinion, on that.
On More Life? Well, yeah. We're talking albums. So what's your favorite album? Top three, I mean. we'll say top two, because the... Yeah.
Yeah, More Life, More Life, and if you're reading this, it's too late. Those are my two.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not an album guy.
Yeah.
You just like songs.
I don't know. I'm more of like an album guy, you know.
No, I mean, I agree with you. I think I don't really care for albums either, because every album's gonna have good songs and bad songs, and it's all opinionated. So,
right. I just feel like Nothing Was the Same was like his best album, like start to finish. You know, minus Started From the Bottom. That fucking song is trash. I can't stand that fucking song.
Started from the bottom, no one here. But obviously, it's doing something well.
Well, it is.
I mean, it's true. I mean, started from the bottom. Right? It's like Kevin Gates would Get It Out the Mud.
That song's fire, though.
I know, but I'm just saying.
that ain't no comparison.
No, I'm just saying, as far as him, like, okay, Drake came from the suburbs. That's his way of saying he getting out the mud.
That was his bottom.
That's it.
Yeah, that's interesting, because everyone's got their own bottom, but many bottoms are probably much lower than many others.
I mean, regardless, ain't we like in the 1% of the world? You know what I'm saying?
Who?
Us.
Us three?
Yeah. Ain't there? Fuck is that? Fuck is that noise?
The 1% of what?
Just like, not like wealth, but just like your, like health, well-being, money. You know what I'm saying? Ain't there some statistic like that? Oh, where there were like some that were basically Well, I mean, not necessarily America, but just in the world in general, that we're relatively, like, well off than other people. You know what I'm saying? You smelling what I'm stepping in? You picking up what I'm putting down over there?
Yeah, I would just say I have...
What you need, man? What you need, bro?
I have...
What you need, Ron?
What?
You need some more... You need some more...
No, it worked. It worked
out. I would just say I have played the hands that I have been dealt properly. Again, like... I feel like people in life have different boundaries. What do you want to call it? Like, thresholds. Let me think how I'll say this. Go ahead.
Like limits or?
No. Like your.
You're good. I'll just sit.
I'm just trying to figure out how to phrase this. I'm trying to figure out how to phrase this.
Yo, what's been like the favorite, like just the like monumental like meme for you guys? Do you think? Because, like, looking back, like, there's, like, the...
Karamba or whatever. Karamba, yeah.
Dude, rest in peace, Karamba, man. Wow, are you going to bring that up, man? That's Ohio's finest, dog. Cincinnati.
Hey, honestly, I thought the little black kid that was looking over like this at the...
He's got the styrofoam cup? Yeah. There's been so many. Then Kermit, like, blew the fuck up. And then even that shit where the, like, I fall in, can't get up lady...
Oh, yeah. Like, and then there was one that was like help, I've taken too big of a dab.
there's been some wild shit.
Yeah, there's been some great ones.
The dude's like looking back with holding the girlfriend's hand, like looking back at the chick walking by.
I haven't seen that one. No.
It's like this dude holding this chick's hand and he's like looking back. He's like...
Oh, like at another girl or something?
Yeah.
All
right. Yeah. So, favorite Vine.
Oh, Vine. I never got into Vines.
I didn't. I mean, you. I was only part, on like Vine on Twitter. That was
on
it.
Twitter. Yeah. Like, I mean, you still see them. Like, it's still like it's still. Yeah. Alive, yeah. But yeah. People still.
But like, I never downloaded the app.
Like, I feel like the hot thing right now is TikTok. I don't have TikTok.
Yeah, but you still see the TikTok if you have like Twitter, even Instagram shit too.
Instagram, yeah, you still see people that post them.
Yeah, but I'm not with that shit.
But the little divine that that I was about to mention was the little black boy. He like delete that shit.
Obviously. we'll
delete have to that shit, Piggy. Delete that shit. He's all, he trying to act all swole. Delete that shit.
The one that stands out for me is that he's like surprise motherfucker.
Surprise.
And then
motherfucker.
He's like all eyes mother, and he just keeps like
small fries motherfucker.
Oh my god, that shit's hilarious. And then
he just keeps popping through the door.
Yeah.
Like, all eyes motherfucker.
Small fry.
Or Unforgettable.
Unforgettable.
It's like going to the small fry for free.
I haven't seen that in so long.
He said,
long.
Yeah. What did he say? He said, we're going to go to...
Oh, the black dude.
When he in the forest. We're going to go to Chick-fil-A. Yeah, and I'm going to be like, yeah, come on, bitch.
Some mayonnaise. Yeah. I remember that shit. Oh my god, my homie loved that fucking shit. He quoted that shit every single day. I felt like every conversation he quoted that shit.
Yeah,
I ain't gonna lie. We for us, it was either that.
Was that a Vine though?
No,
I felt like that was
that was YouTube.
Yeah, okay, because there was like a documentary. There's like a series of that shit. I think.
Yeah, he went like he was like moving through the forest.
Yeah.
Kind of looked like he was going through Blair Witch.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, to go back to what you're talking about, the 1%. I remember what I was thinking about now. the line of error that I have because of financial is much less than I feel like, or in just ours in general is less than most. Like we have to be very careful with what we do. We are blessed, yes, but I don't know, I feel like the
we
the,
have So you think that we have more to lose?
Strategic. In a
sense. No, not necessarily we have more to lose. I'm saying...
I'm just saying us compared to, say, the mass majority of the world. Like, I feel like we have more to lose than anyone else. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, us in school, and we just be like, oh, fuck it. Like, yeah, mm-hmm. if we actually worked 3-4 times as hard, we can, you know, get our own shit and stuff like that. But if they do it over there, the family yeah. like, okay, you good. You still go to college? And I'm doing like a career yeah. or whatever.
Dude, so are you saying that like Americans are held to like a higher standard? Is that what you're saying?
Or? Well, I'm just saying that our system puts more of a stressor on us. As far as like, you know, financially and school and stuff like that.
Well, so that is true because I feel like especially out here, I mean, not necessarily out here, but like in like the States, I guess you would say it's kind of like it's weird to be staying with your parents.
Staying with them? Or
yeah, like past like 18 even. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, other countries.
But other countries, they like 27, like 30.
They embracing that shit.
Still with their parents and shit. Like, that shit's crazy, yeah.
And they embrace
That's true.
It. They like, yeah. Like, hey, what you gonna do when you get home? Oh, yeah, I'm gonna go. My mom got me some ravioli.
Like,
yeah.
like,
damn.
They ain't
yeah, it's
about,
crazy. Like, I mean, I was like talking to my cousin the other weekend, and he's like, oh, you know, man, I'm getting ready to make a move, you know, to a different state, you know, and he's older than I am. And I was like, get ready, you know, it's interesting. It keeps you on your toes. I was like, shit, I did that 8 years ago. Like, yeah. you know, so it's just interesting. Like,
man, that would have been so dope to go to school outside of fucking out of state, man.
Oh, but out of state tuition was just ridiculous, though.
But yeah, man, that shit would have been crazy.
Mm-hmm. Especially if you went to like, man, even if you went to
here,
if you went to Indiana and just went to like Bloomington.
Oh,
or
yeah.
You'd have still been.
Yo, I use nuts, man. Shout out.
Shout out, Lil Five.
Yeah. Even like Fort Wayne's crazy, man.
Oh yeah, they get it down in Fort Wayne.
Yeah,
went to the little club over there.
What's been your guys? Because you guys kind of like traveled somewhat like within the States. What do you think? I mean, I guess another question is what, like, where do you see yourself like chilling? You know what I'm saying? Forever.
When I'm older.
Honestly, I don't.
Or just in
general.
I don't
know. Just I feel like if I'm gonna settle down somewhere, it's gonna be somewhere that's warm. I already know that for a fact. But where at exactly, I don't know.
Yeah. Sorry, you know what I mean? I could hear him fucking get. Kind of lost focus.
Hey, it's better than eating chips, right?
Yeah, I was like, what the fuck is going on over here?
No, I don't know. Yeah, I would like to, you know, be, you know, this is just hopeful, but I would like to be able to own multiple houses across, you know, or at least a couple, to where I could be like, okay, like I'm gonna have work here, you know, and then rent this one out and work here or live here and, you know, rent these out, mate, you know. I don't know, I'd like to have something fucking small back where I'm from, at least in the area, you know, just to go home and see friends and family for short durations of time, possibly pick up some work.
So you don't really
I don't think
you don't have like a destination picked out, I guess you would say.
No, I don't. I mean, right now, like I said, I think that's too hard to depict.
Not even a climate, not even
I was gonna say, because like Ron kinda answered it even though he didn't, but like it, like warm weather kind of narrows it down.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
but you just
honestly, like I feel like Arizona is a perfect place to live. Like it really is.
Yeah.
Yo,
you. Honestly, I feel like Nevada, like Vegas. If it wasn't for Vegas, man, like Nevada would honestly be a real dope place. But but outside of Vegas, like there ain't nothing
in Nevada.
Nothing there. Yeah.
Tell me about anything other than what is those spaceships or some shit like that? Do you ever hear about New Mexico?
Oh, no.
No.
But honestly, bro, because I drove through there to come out here, and I was like, I fuck with Albuquerque. I don't know about living
but,
there.
But that's what I'm saying. That's all that it has.
Yeah. And like Santa Fe. And the only reason people know Santa Fe is because of them fucking hot air balloons. Yeah.
So it's just like some states, you'd be like,
what is in like North Dakota or South Dakota?
Yeah, you driving by on E, you like, I've been stopping.
And it's absolutely nothing.
There's your
it's
answer.
Cabins. Like, it's kind of like where, whatchamacallit from? Like Wyoming?
Wyoming.
They're all one in the
well,
same.
Well, ain't it like right, next to, like right next to Wyoming? Like that. Yeah, that not like the region. Pacific Northwest, but like the whole fucking... Between the Pacific and like Wisconsin and shit, that the all them states kind of get like
Montana.
They get lost together.
It's like
yeah.
cousin
like, what
fucking
the fuck
territory.
Is Montana? Like, what is Montana? Like, what do
you
mean
Montana?
Saying?
Like, yeah, exactly. But like, where is Montana? Nobody can point that shit out. Either. I'm you know
it's the biggest one up there.
It is. It's the border. I got no fucking idea where Montana is, man. Come on, man. We're giving you a little teaching.
Nah, it's just the biggest one up there.
I don't even doesn't know where it's at.
Yeah, he said Wyoming. I'm like, man, I don't know.
When you get to that area, though, you get to the point to where it's like your neighbors are like 3 and 4 and 5 miles in between you. You'd be like, what the hell are your neighbors at? Motherfucker over there getting killed.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just like wild ass shit, man. You got to drive like 2 hours to go to the store or some shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, that just ain't. Mm-hmm. I just ain't about that life, man. There ain't no civilization.
Mm-hmm. I don't know, but I feel like. I mean, I obviously might. At some point, I couldn't see my neighbors growing up. That was just me. But I do feel as if growing up in kind of that territory, or that those types of regions where you're maybe more prone to living off of the land or doing yard work and garden work and planting and stuff like that does teach you a little bit more than sometimes just growing, you know, like I said, moving out here, and seeing a lot of the people that grew up in Scottsdale and just how their mentalities are. A lot of them, I could just tell, were just kind of handed a lot of things and didn't have to go through those experiences such as like shoveling snow or cutting wood or gardening or doing, you know, simple house chores like outside.
Does that make you like think less of a, like say a girl, for instance, would that make you think less of her because like she's using like daddy's credit card? Or would you kind of give her the benefit of the doubt because
it depends
it's all
on,
she
it,
knows?
It depends on the mentality. Like, you can come from money and not be an asshole or stuck up.
Yeah, but that's kind of what I'm saying. Like,
if you come from that background, like, there's nothing wrong with that. Like, those are the cards that you were dealt.
Yeah, but do you like not even fuck with her, or do you kind of give her a chance, maybe give her the benefit of the doubt because she could be oblivious to hella shit.
Like,
and
what
she,
else
like,
is
like
there,
her
yeah.
attitude could be she has no idea like what's going on around her, so she doesn't even think about like other people and how they may react to something she does or says, you know.
Again, it's all mentality, and you know, I don't know, like I said,
you guys believe
I'm
in soulmates?
yeah
you do,
yeah.
But to go back to what I was saying,
I feel like it's difficult to find a soulmate though, especially in this world.
Honestly,
All right.
I just feel like it's just one thing to where it's like you just gotta be able to. I say pay attention, especially when it comes to women. Like, to as far as like signs and stuff like that, then you can get a better understanding.
What do you mean, like astronomical signs?
No, just like coming off of her. Like, you can, okay, as a guy, you know what I mean. Just like women do. You know, you do certain shit, and then you be like, okay, I'm gonna see what kind of response I'm gonna get from this. You know what I mean? Uh-huh. Like, you know, you want the one that you want for your soulmate, and that you're gonna find in that soulmate is the one that's gonna be more caring, the one that's gonna be about you to assist you even in the dark times as they do in the good times. You know what I mean? So those are the ones
you want. Dude, what?
Nothing. I was just
no. I was done. Like,
no, I just said, yeah, I just, yeah. I just couldn't hear him.
Oh yeah. I think he was telling you to talk into the mic.
Yeah.
But
it's hard to like move. That's what I found. Like starting off, like you just gotta kind of fuck. And then I always find myself like ending up fucking with this thing just to like move in one place for a little bit and then like move around, you know.
I feel that.
It's, yeah, it's tough. But
I'm perfect, man.
Yeah. Like, some of my friends came out and did them. They'd be, like, talking, the fucking mic's over here.
Like, you know, I'm just like, yo. No, I don't, you know, like, I feel like it's just someone that you can kind of get along with and help each other along the way. And it's like, I don't know. I mean, I think I'm not a very confrontational person, and I don't like getting into arguments. Obviously, I think anyone in life, you're going to get into little scurries or whatever it might be, but it's just how you deal with that, you know.
So I mean, do you believe in a soulmate? How about that?
Yes, but it's
a soulmate. One.
Yes.
Really?
Because it's like,
wow. You know, that's crazy.
So you think it's normal for people to have multiple mates like at a time?
I think you're like, looking so, into it a little okay. too so, hard already, but
so,
like
so what, I think this let me tell okay, you what, okay. I think, what I think. I think what you're saying is that soulmates in with that with within your life, that's why people also get married multiple times because they find their what? Soulmate, right?
But I mean,
in a sense, so this is what I'm saying, yeah, though.
But they obviously was wrong.
They were wrong. but I'm just saying, that's what I look at it as. Like, if soulmates, like, you know, you can find somebody that is perfect for you. Like, over time, like, people do change. Like, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? And stuff does happen. So if y'all mutually separate and then you go through some years or however long it is, and then you find somebody else, you know what I mean, that's perfect for you, that you want in your life. Like,
yeah.
I consider that, you know, a soulmate. What about you?
Yeah, no, I mean, I think it's, I feel like it's one of those things where it literally takes years and years and years and years of building. Because it's like, I think that's why I just think it's interesting when people are taking like pictures with each other like a month in and like, oh, I love you, I love you, I love you. And
yeah.
like all this and posting it on like all the social media outlets for everyone to see. And then it's like 3 months later, what the fuck happened? Like, I don't know. It's just interesting me to like the fact that people can't even like go through certain things without telling you just like, especially like relationship stuff without having the world. Yeah, yeah. What's going on? I'm like, why the fuck does that need to be told to Facebook and everyone?
Dog,
like,
I mean, you're preaching to the choir. But,
yeah. Like there's know, shit like, that there's literally shit that you should keep to yourself in this world, and between certain relationships, yeah. like whether it's me or you, or me and you, or me and Alec, or me and my parents, or your spouse at that moment.
It's 100% true.
But like, why the fuck, like that, I feel like, yeah, that's just like giving each other's privacy away mm-hmm. for what?
But I mean, back to the soulmate
thing.
I mean, so,
but I mean, that's true though. Like that is honestly true.
What?
Like as far as like you, what you're saying, but I'm just gonna ask you this question. So if
I'm gonna let you finish.
Hold up. I'm gonna head out.
It was just basically asking a question about what you were saying. Like,
yeah,
but I forgot the shit now.
Oh man.
Damn. He started giggling.
Oh shit, man, my bad.
What? No, you good? but to go back to the soulmate.
Yeah.
No, I don't know. I feel like just finding someone who fits your values and like just obviously everyone's got different tastes of whether it's music, food, you know, hobbies, interests. No one's gonna have the same fucking thing. And even if you do, sometimes that's not the best fit. So yeah. Finding a person who just fits your ethics and morals and supports you, I feel like is like that person that I at least look for. Or try to look for.
My thing is, I feel like it's not like it's not based off location necessarily, but I think that plays a part. Like if I was in some other country, you know what I'm saying? Like the chances of like coming across somebody like and developing some sort of relationship, I feel like would be pretty high. You know what I'm saying?
Like if you found if you were like just out, touring or traveling the world, and you ran into someone and you just kick it off.
Yeah,
like, yeah, you're gonna remember. So, like I think it like.
No. But I'm saying like as far as like the soulmate. So I feel like if that was to happen, then something like big could come from that. And I'm not even like here. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So that's why I feel like you can have like soul mates is what I was getting at. But
So like if you
multiple, because
if you meet multiple people that fit your mindset mm-hmm. along the way,
yeah.
But obviously, you know. All right, let me ask you this though: do you think money plays a factor into that?
Into what?
Being able to find difference, like if you're traveling across, like, I mean, I can't just be like, hey, I'm gonna go find my soulmate in China. Like, I can't fucking afford that.
Dog, you could get a round trip ticket, $300-$400.
But where the fuck am I gonna stay? What am I gonna do? How am I gonna supply my, or like,
brothel?
Yeah, I mean, they got brothels, they got hostels.
You know, it might not be the soulmate that I'm, I don't know. So that's why I just want your thought.
But honestly, like, I mean, you could have, like, you could stay in a spot for like $20-$30 a night. It's not hard, man. People make this shit complicated, dude. It ain't.
No, I mean, I get that, but life is a little bit more complicated than that. Like, you know,
you just gotta let go, man. I feel like you would just be worried. You can't be worried, man.
I mean, I wouldn't be
Well, you just said you. Where am I gonna stay? How am I gonna support me? You know what I'm saying?
So not necessarily that, but it's like
you just gotta let go, man. That's all. That's the beauty of like traveling. Like you have no idea what the fuck you're about to get into.
Yeah, no, but I'm not even saying that. I'm just saying like in terms of certain other obligations that in financial whatever, you know, if in mine it'd be student loans. If I didn't have that burden over my head.
I mean, you don't have to pay anything.
Well, if I want a house and if I want a future with my soulmate, then yeah, I might have to.
But okay,
I think you'd be all right.
So, but the thing is okay. What was your question though?
Did you get to your question?
But he's gonna have student loans for the rest of his life.
Yeah, but I'm saying like there's a point I feel like where you can kind of place yourself to not have to worry about that as much. Like when you're able to be like, you know, now I'm living comfortably. I have a job that I can go and take these vacations on,
right
where I'm not, you know, where I know I'm gonna be.
Dude,
like
it's now or never. Yeah, exactly.
I
literally remember a conversation I was having with this girl like in college. I was at work and I was getting so pissed off because she kept saying something about like, oh, I just want to like retire and do all this shit. And I'm like, yo, you can mm-hmm. literally do that today, right now. Like, what the fuck is stopping you?
That is true. This?
Yeah. What the fuck was your question, though? Did you ask your question?
Yeah, I was saying about soulmate. Mm-hmm. You said, okay, I'm going to go wherever and try and find my soulmate. I mean, yeah, I'm going to, let's say this, like, I'm going to Puerto Vallarta in 3 weeks. Like, if I...
Bam!
Yeah, you know, like, sure, if I find my soulmate there, then so be it. But again, it's like, it was kind of like...
Well, how long are you staying?
Just a weekend. But it's not like I'm going down there for a month or anything. You know what I mean? So,
I mean,
yo, what it really comes down to as well is effort.
But
you
my,
know what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely. Effort is key. But on both sides.
Yeah. I mean,
but all I'm saying, my question to you was, do you think finances play a,
he did ask that.
Yeah.
No, I mean, Like,
fortunately, I'm going down with a bachelor party
right.
who is able to help me get down there.
Yeah, I mean,
I would never be like, hey, yeah, I'm just going to go down and take a trip to Puerto Vallarta by myself and try and find, not right now at least,
yeah.
but
no,
when my finances are better set in stone, I might be able to do so on my own.
I'll answer and say like yes and no. Like,
yes.
Obviously, yeah. if you're able to just like, even just like simply like go out and like say you get a table or whatever and you do and you're like doing that like a lot, you're gonna have like a lot of people around you and your circle is gonna get bigger, right? But at the end of the day, like none of those people is fucking with you until you started showing up there. You know what I'm saying?
Where, around here?
Like, or? No, I'm just saying like a club, a bar. Like,
yeah, that's why. That's why I don't, that's why I don't really care to go out much.
You know,
honestly,
what I'm saying? But they started coming around you because they saw you at the same spot all the
being
time.
Being regular, flexing money, all this type of shit.
So,
and again, I think that's
so
why.
Like, yes, and
I think that's why like a lot of people lose themselves in larger cities like that, yeah, in clubs and type of shit.
Ain't there some? there's like some fucking. Like a specific amount of money that, like, beyond that, they did some study that that happiness no longer exists.
I don't know.
You know what I'm saying?
Honestly, I feel like it's...
Like, it's no longer about, like, happiness. It's about
material things.
Yeah, yeah. I feel like... Or these people aren't happier than the other people, you know?
I feel like it's about that from the beginning.
What?
Because, like, about the money. Because, like, you're literally fighting for that. Like, you want the best of this and the best of that. You know what I mean? Just for yourself. So, I feel like you're always going to be fighting for, you know...
The next best thing.
Yeah, the next best thing.
But what
I'm saying is about, like, the whole happiness. Like, I feel like that you're always going to be doing that. I think happiness is something that's deeper than in yourself, within yourself, and not just about the money. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's just gonna buy those clothes that's gonna make you look nice and stuff like that.
Fuck, I don't want nice clothes.
But I mean, deep down, people are rotten and want to go commit suicide
because they have all this money. Yeah.
But I mean, it probably ain't just because of that. It's just something that's going on between them and within themselves. Mm-hmm. Like, we don't know what they're going through. Like, they probably was, you know, molested and, you know, done with when they were a kid. Like, you don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like, we don't know their, like, people's stories. That's one of the reasons why I always say, like, I can't judge anybody until I have a conversation.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess that's a different way to look at it. Yeah. But I mean, would you, I guess it also comes down to, like, do you want to make the effort to have that kind of conversation, you know?
What,
like,
I mean,
like, how would you get to that point?
I mean, you just ask
what with certain individuals, you mean? Or?
I just feel like I'm kind of blunt, so
yeah.
I don't try to hold back, and it's not about. I feel like when you're upfront and you're showing, you know, somewhat of yourself at first, like, that's what, you know, they're gonna respect more than you trying to be like.
I just
tiptoe around subjects.
Sorry, sweetheart.
I just feel like sometimes people say things and, like, do things to kind of make you, like, want to ask them something. And then so then that's how I look at it.
Like,
and
sometimes
then,
beating around the bush. And then, like,
yeah, and then so like they'll bring up a topic, and then they I can tell they want me to ask them something, and I'm like, I ain't doing it, man.
Oh yeah, just so they can just,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
talk,
yeah.
And that's one thing where I think I was talking to somebody about that. It's just one thing you can ask somebody one question about themselves, and they can go on for forever. Just asking somebody about themselves. So that's why that person, like you said, just brought Will's bringing up that, because.
And I feel like you could tell, because if they start asking, like, shit about you, then it's actually, like, going to go somewhere. But some people just, like, keep going on about
them.
Honestly,
I just feel like sometimes that's, it's like, it's what you're saying, but also, like, you know how you fish around in a conversation to see what will spark something that they will want to talk about?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's like, you know, you'll ask a question and it just go dead. So then you, like, well, shit, I don't know. Damn, why cows got spots? Why the sky blue? Like,
but yeah, I don't know. Just in terms of, like, going back to what you're talking about, like, money and happiness. I don't know. I mean, it's a mix of both. Like, you know, I've gotten to a point where, like, I don't care about material things. Like, I would, you know, I could literally do just fine in what I'm doing, living out of a car, going, you know, I always, you know,
would you do that what the fuck is that, the minivan shit that they're doing now? Damn, what the fuck is that called?
As long as I had you know, and I know that sounds dumb, but as long as I had internet to be able to post my work to get more work, I would live in a fucking van and travel the world.
That's easy money, dude. You could do that.
But. So I mean again, that's the goal at some point.
Yeah.
Like, I want to be able to just travel the world and meet different cultures.
So
and
my
do,
question
and
to
do,
you
do
is,
my work.
Eric.
Yes.
So when we get down to talking about, like, women and stuff like that, you say that you don't care, but then why is money always one of the first questions or things you bring up to try to differentiate, like Scottsdale, but there's guys in Scottsdale from the guys in Phoenix when the guys in Phoenix get just as much money as guys in Scottsdale. You know what I mean? Like, what's like?
I'm not. Yeah, following along with what you're saying.
No, I'm just saying, like, okay, so. When he started talking earlier, he said something about the difference between the guys in Scottsdale, right? And then he asked a question about the money thing. So I was curious as to if he's saying that he doesn't care about money and stuff like that, why is all his questions referencing money and what other people may have?
I'm just saying it is helpful to have currency. So, and I don't think any right. of us
are
can
you referring
that.
To like the soulmate question?
No, I'm just saying all the questions in general. Like, well, all
but he was saying like, do finances play a role in the soulmate?
I know he was asking you, but why I was saying it's still a question that was reverted back to somewhere to finances or currency.
Okay.
No, so that's why I was curious. I'm just saying, like, I feel like when you have more available time in your day, you can spend and do more things and be comfortable with a soulmate or a friend or whoever it might be that you're, you know, whether it's friends, you know, cool, hey guys, let's go get dinner or whatever. Or if it's a female, you know, you can take them out to some nice place and spend more time with them. So it is nice to have additional funds, but again, that's not the focal point of a relationship.
I mean, that didn't answer.
I was going to say, I don't think that answers the question.
Well, all right, so elaborate.
I was just curious as to why all your...
I was, like, trying to process, like, trying to figure out...
Why all your questions that you had was referencing towards some sort of form of currency. Yeah. So, whereas if we were talking about something, then you ask about, like, earlier, there was the Scottsdale boys, and... Then it was you just said something. You asked him the question about
the soulmate being and then, money playing a factor.
And so that's why I was just curious as to you're saying now, like, you can live in a shoebox basically, mm-hmm. but then you're still sitting right here and like all your questions are fueled towards like currency.
Again, you've got to be able to afford to live in a van, or like, you know, at least buy
in a
van
down by the river.
No bears.
Yo, rest in peace, man. Legend.
No, I guess to just go off of that, like the one thing, you know, I always wonder, like, you know, are homeless people without debt honestly sometimes happier than people with hundreds and thousands of dollars of debt? Like,
probably.
Yeah, you know.
I mean, that's why you got people
because
that
they're free.
You said homeless people that are out of debt?
That have no debt, like no really.
I'm going to say that a vast majority of those homeless people have a lot of debt though.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, there are those, you know.
But I mean, you're going to go down there and fingerprint them, you're going to know who they are.
Yeah.
there are people, you know, that literally will just be like, fuck it, like, I don't want a house, I don't want cars, I don't want anything, I don't want burdens of life holding me back, to where they just go fucking wanderlust basically.
Okay, but do you see the homeless people being that choose to do that and then go, oh, the Dens keep talking about, like, oh, those Scottsdale people and acting like that, and when they chose to be right where they are? That make any sense?
I don't know. I guess I don't talk to homeless people. No.
Like, why are you taking it so literal?
No, I'm not. Like,
I mean, but, like, to go off your, like, wanderlust thing, I don't, like, the... It's like a fucking, what's a phase? Not a phase. Fugazi. Fugazi.
Fugazi.
But, like, bro, people are saying that they're, like, they are that or would define themselves as that. But then you, like, posting about it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, you.
So you think wanderlust is, like, literally just going off the grid and,
you,
like,
no
lit,
one, like,
yeah, like, no
one
no knows
has
where
heard
the fuck
you in
are.
10 years,
yeah.
bro.
No, that's crazy. Yeah.
Like, you, like, then you are actually, like that, living.
You're off the grid.
You are living.
You are living.
They used to have a show.
Okay,
about
so
that.
To go, yeah. All right. So to follow up on that, do you think we are a normal civilized, or, like, normal civilization, how we live?
No.
Or people that live, you know, like tribes and like the rainforest.
I'm sure I would rather be doing that shit. I mean, I wouldn't rather be doing that shit because that's some wild ass shit, you know.
Yeah, I wouldn't rather be doing that shit because that's some wild ass shit.
Yeah, but like some survivor type shit. Like,
you in the middle of the damn Sahara.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, I
retract my fucking statement.
Are we the right ones like, or are they?
You gotta sleep around.
It was the heat of the moment, man. I just, you know, emotions was flowing. I said it and I take it back. What did you ask though?
No, I was just saying, like, are we the, like, normal ones, or are they, or are we the outcast?
I don't know, man. I don't know. I mean, are we even alive?
I think it just depends on your point of view.
I don't know.
I think it depends on your point of view.
Mm-hmm. POV?
POV. It's a good one. It's a good one. It's a good angle. It's a good angle.
What, like, elaborate, right? <Rob. laughs> I'm trying not to laugh, so you stop laughing.
It's a great angle.
I forgot his question now.
Fucking it's POV. Then it was.
Are we civil? Are we civilized? Yeah. Are we
normal?
Or,
are we normal?
Not.
Oh, well, I said
how we live because it's like
they can sit there and be like they're. The way they live is the universal master way, and then we can sit right here and we could be like, oh,
that's just like the Amish and shit too, though, you know.
Yeah, I mean, but even like growing up in Pennsylvania, like I've seen Amish people starting to drive fucking vans, and I'm not even kidding, like.
To be like, what?
There's different
that's
tiers.
That's what I was trying to figure out. I'm like, English, what the fuck is that?
There's
that,
different tiers
is
to
that
it.
A type
like,
of grit?
Like, you know, I've seen them driving vans, and I've seen
cell phones. And then they probably got Instagram, and then they're posting, with the horses and shit. Like I made, like,
they
you
got
know
the
what
horses
I'm saying?
In
like,
the back.
Yeah,
those
fucking,
are, those
like,
are,
you're not.
Those are Mennonite.
I literally played hockey. You know, I played hockey with a dude who is a Mennonite, and like, he lived like you and I, like,
yeah. But he's
I don't know.
Still
I think that's part of the problem too. Like, I guess nothing's normal, but like we're all not so different anyway.
No,
but people try to differentiate everything and like put people in boxes and shit like that. So
fuck boxes.
Not like literally like
fuck boxes.
You know, but
I mean they kind of do. When you got to check on the application, when you got to check black or...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they put you in the box.
Oh, man.
That's true.
This is on a job application. You check black.
Well, I was saying like
hey, I'm going to just start
putting them in boxes. And shit. I started thinking about
no, no comment. Mm-hmm. It's fucking 2020. I am what I am.
Right? Me too.
Yo, oh, my God. Dude, you know... You know how, oh my God, that's so crazy. I should change my name, like, on a job application just to, like, me too. That would be hilarious. Holy shit. What do you guys think about, like, the gender shit and stuff? I seen in Arizona they denied, like, transgender people to be able to participate in
sports.
Yeah, in, like, if, like, a dude becomes a girl...
He can't play.
Yeah,
that shit's wild.
He can't play in girl sports. Yeah.
Like, all right. Let me ask you this. So it's like, would I like? I mean, would I go anywhere if I fucking chopped my ding dong off and got a flap of skin? Like, would I be the next Bruce? Fucking what's his name?
Probably.
Fucking Juana man.
Juana man.
You probably.
Yeah, that movie's
honestly,
awesome.
You probably would.
But that's so weird. I don't know. It's just so interesting.
What, like cutting your dick off or the flap of skin or like
play,
like
Caitlyn Jenner
like
type shit?
Pissing
like,
whilst you're sitting down? What's weird here? Right?
Man, you just can't come back from that.
I mean,
hey, what you? Hey, you go home every day and you got your dick in a jar.
It's my dick in a box. Yeah.
Hey, you said don't put it in a box, but here we are.
Oh man, could you imagine that, man?
No, I can't. No, I can't.
Up, man.
I can't.
Why'd you even
so
say
it's
that?
Like, it's like, you know, and then it's like, oh man, you know, I don't like this. I think I'm going to put my ding dong back
on. Yeah, yeah. Like after a day, you got like it's a 7-day free trial.
How,
you know?
You go to Walmart, you pick out the new one. Like,
Hey, let me get
but
the one.
I wonder, just gotta give your email, like, set up a password, so maybe social weird. Security.
Like,
just
how does that
gotta
affect
do a
you
check.
Mentally? Like, oh my god.
Hey, that's your testosterone, man. It's gonna. You're going to have to start taking shots for the rest of your life.
How the fuck does that
I mean, you got to start, like, pill popping as soon as you want to, you know? And then, like, I don't.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. Yeah. I'm good.
Well, I'm just asking, like, what's your thoughts on it? Like, you know, I think we all can.
Neither.
I mean, I feel like, okay. We sit in a world where, you know, we say that everybody can do whatever the hell they want to do, and which that's honestly true.
Yeah. At the end of the day, you're not stopping.
I just feel like it's one of those things where it's like it still should be at a certain age where if you want to chop your dick off or you want to attach your dick, you know what I mean? Then you can do that at a certain age.
But,
so say so, but, 21. All right.
Right.
At 21,
I get it.
You got the opportunity to where, like, if you finally, you like, all right, I already tried.
But bro, some people,
you know.
So I honestly feel like because not that I like grew up around a lot of gay people, but I feel like I've seen a lot of shit. All right, so
you and me both.
Huh? I think some people are so fucking like in tune with themselves that mm-hmm. they could be 5 years old, bro, and they can know that that's what the like something's not right.
Oh yeah.
So like, what would you do in those cases?
So you're saying in terms of like a 5 year old being like, "Mommy, like, why is this?"
No.
Like a 5 year old just being like, recognizing the fact
that a dude
like,
has
like
a
gay,
vagina,
gay maybe
or
whatever,
like how that,
or also recognizing the fact like, I'm a boy, but like I should be a girl. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying?
I mean, that's where
I think there's like very special cases, like.
But that's why kids can know. That's why I'm saying to go to 21, to where it's like.
But that's why I'm saying that because I don't think that,
like,
it should be 21.
Well, I'm just saying, come on, you gonna sit.
No,
there,
I'm just I'm
you
saying
sit
so.
You gonna sit there at 5 years old? And
no,
go,
bro.
And go
I'm
let
not,
him
I'm
and be
not,
like,
I'm not saying all right,
well, I'm gonna chop your dick off, you little 5 year old. Winky, because he's five.
Like, you take it away too. Like, this is just wild out, man. All I'm saying is like that there's very special cases that like a kid will like know at a very, very young age.
Yeah.
I think there are signs of it. You know, it's like if a dude's like, "Hey mom, will you buy me makeup instead of like G.I. Joe's?"
Yeah.
I feel like that's kind of like a, all right, you know, yeah, I will, but mm-hmm. that's a little off.
Something like that.
I don't know. So to me, like the earlier that they could get that process started, then they should be able to do that. Is what I'm kind of getting at. Because there is a gray area. I'm not saying it's like the best, but I'm just saying that like a lot of time, like, can be wasted in a way. You know what I'm saying?
Like, you mean trying to force someone to live a way that they don't
yeah.
want to live?
I mean that, and just like think about the time that they could make up, rather than waiting until like age like 18, 21.
But, okay,
you know
but
what
are you? But what are you gaining from having?
Then they can finally feel fucking like comfortable
in their skin.
You know what I'm saying? Like, could
well,
you imagine
I mean,
that? Like not.
Not being able to be you.
Yeah.
Okay, if we going down that road and do that then. No, for real. No, listen to this. If we go down that road and do that then, like, why the hell are the, you know, why are kids in school? They can choose to not go to school. Why the hell they gotta be in school? Like, you gonna sit there and chop something off because it's them and they person just because they choose that at a certain age? Like,
yeah, I mean,
you're
why do
already,
kids go to school? I don't fucking know. Yeah.
That's
because
what
it's
that's
what
I'm,
we're forced to, you yeah. know, told to do.
But
yeah,
that's, but that's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
If it's something that's like that, like, all right, well, kids shouldn't go to school. Kids, you want to eat ice cream when you wake up? Go eat ice cream.
Well, I mean, it just goes back to, like, literally, you could do whatever the fuck you. If you don't want to go to school, you don't gotta go to school.
Yeah,
it's simple.
I mean, that is true, but I'm just saying, as far as like coming from a kid's perspective, like when you get older, it's like, okay, yeah,
yeah you look back and you're like, oh shit, I actually could have.
But like you're saying, you're going about
5 years old. I can start wilding out at that age.
But
be like, I am not going to school. I'm doing anything possible.
Okay,
you're
going to a different age now. We're talking about a 5 year old.
Okay.
You're talking about 5 year old. So a 5 year old, you're going to just be like, all right, bro, you can go to the club you want to.
Hey man, as long as he's buying me that 1942, I don't give a damn.
Hey, you ever seen that?
I'm gonna help him open up a fucking credit card too and just run that bitch up.
Hey, you ever seen that? You ever see that meme with the little kid at the party and he got like the little birthday cake? He got all the liquor bottles around him, and it's like all his parents around him, and the meme like. When it's your birthday, but your mama partying.
Oh, yeah. That's crazy.
But I mean, that's why it's like a really gray area as far as like.
I just said five. I'm not saying five is ideal.
Yeah, like, but I'm just going. But, I was just yeah, going off. Yeah, of,
but
you know,
but
age.
Like so, I'm just all I'm saying is like the point is just some people know what they want from a very young age. That's it. That's it. And to basically, like I'm saying, just like waste all that time when they know what they want. Just other people is telling them different, clearly, because it's not normal, quote unquote. And then just
now the next question goes: who's gonna pay for this dick chopping?
I mean, hopefully I don't gotta cross that bridge, but I'm just
dick chopping off. Hey, where them financials at?
he could be talking to one. He could be over there talking to his best friend, talking about some. Hey, you want to be the next Lorena Bobbitt?
Yeah, Jesus.
Just start with the force. Hey,
that's the girl. She cut off some dude's dick. Oh, that's crazy, man.
Wild world,
yo,
wild
man.
But yeah, that's a huge gray area. That's crazy. And then the thing about it though too is just like, you know, I feel like it's one of those things where it's like everybody feels, it's like it's a medium. That's why I said like 21 or 18. At least at 18, I mean, you make your own decisions.
It's definitely made like progress.
Yeah,
for sure.
Especially if you
because it used to be like nah, like people ain't even talking about this shit. But now it's like so like brought to the forefront. So that, I mean, that's cool.
All right, since we on that subject, so how you feel about the whole bathroom situation though?
Well, that's kind of what I was getting at with the question that I was asking earlier. Mm-hmm. But the
bathroom, like what you like, just
oh
the
like
joint, like a joint bathroom.
Yeah. Yeah, like, okay. You know, if you say you used to be a guy and then you go into the girl's bathroom and try to use the girl's bathroom, like, you cool? You should be, like, y'all cool with that? Because, I mean, you know what I'm saying? I can find somebody wig and some shit. I can go in the bathroom and be like, "Hey, look, I'm good."
Yeah, you know, like that shit's weird.
I mean, that's just like the locker room. Like, said, if there's a gay dude in there, like,
yeah,
how do you feel about
yeah,
that?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know.
I mean, at the end of the day, okay, I can understand. Like, if it's another
male,
I'm
gonna cover my shit regardless. But
well, I mean, for us guys, that's different. To where it's like. If a girl want to come in the bathroom and be like, "Hey, look, I'm about to change some shit," we're going to be like, okay, you good. We're going to keep doing our thing.
Well, I mean, there's just double standards in everything.
Yeah,
and this is fucking crazy, yeah.
And then we go in a girl's bathroom and they're like, get out, what the fuck? But at the same time, it's like, look, I got hair like you. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? I walk
good
like you.
Googly moo.
Everything is the same, but something just go.
Yeah. Until it gets chopped off.
I get chopped off in 2 weeks.
Until the financial comes
like
into play.
You got like a
chopped off card in your pocket. Man. Look, I'm getting chopped off soon. So
we're good.
I'm just practicing.
I mean, I don't know. I mean, the bathroom thing don't really bother me. You know, just I guess just make all of them fucking guy and girl. Just that solves everything.
Oh, just like.
But just know I'm leaving the seat up. I don't give a fuck.
Okay, so go to that though. All right, you don't went into like so many like guy bathrooms to where you see like 3 billion pubes look like somebody been peeing on the wall. Yeah. Not even the urinal. Yeah. Like, how would a girl feel? Just
what
she go down to the seat. It's like
a big furry thing.
Yeah, I can't relate to that.
Like you can pet it.
Yeah.
Oh man.
I don't know.
It's just guys are just so nasty as far as like when it comes to the bathroom.
Yeah, hygiene.
Mm-hmm. Like girls being there making it all perfect and shit.
Yeah, that is true. A girl's bathroom always nicer than a But girls just nasty, dude. God, man.
Hey, but the crazy part, ours always smell better, but it looks nasty. How the hell it smell good, but look nasty?
Now you got me like thinking about like just
sanitary.
Girls just fucking hair everywhere and shit, man. Just fucking.
Oh, that's why that one house would have been perfect. You know, when you got a girl like that.
The one, first one?
That no.
We was talking the other day. The first one, man. We
that
fucked
first
up.
One was dope. Man. No, but then the second one. I'm talking about the second one.
Oh, I don't think I've seen that one.
They had like the split.
Yeah, you didn't. Oh my god!
It had like the master had like a split vanity. So then it had like a whole section to where it could be like if you had a girl, you could have her over there so she could have her own shit. And it was on the other side of the bathroom.
Oh,
fuck up her own space.
You can be over there. Go by the closet. Yeah. Fuck that. But yeah, we definitely fucked up both of those. But I mean,
yeah. Those are like 10 times dope. We fucked up. But yeah, this is cool. Yeah, you know? Fuck it. I graduate one day. God damn it.
I mean, it was but it was a crazy process though.
It was way more difficult than it needed to be, man.
It was a crazy process.
I don't think it. I mean, it was just the circumstances that we had come to us. And
we had like what, a month.
Yeah,
you came in a month later, right? Well, the last month.
Yeah.
So that's when it came to four.
Well, actually, I have no idea. So.
So I think it was like the last month. So then it was like it made it like, all right, we need four.
Well, because it was like we were looking at three for like probably a month, and then we
were bullshitting at the gym one day. Yeah. Yeah, and then.
And then I was like, well, no fucking
shit. And then I think
shit.
Later like, that day, because I was telling you I had to go, I'd like head out because I had to go to work. And then, then I think you texted me later that day.
And I was like, no, well, we're looking for another place. Yeah, I was like, you know, it's only going to be cheaper. So
right, yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, then it's just cooler, you know, just actually like having the studios and all that shit's cool. It's just like, I don't know, man. It's just like kind of lonely in a way, you know.
Oh yeah,
I feel like, especially in today's age, it's not really good to be
by yourself
in that headspace. Yeah. You know, it's just not.
But yeah, at the same time, if you can sit there and you can try to save and stuff like that, to where when you got a significant other that you move in together, then that's different. You know what I mean? Like,
right.
I can understand. Like I feel like a lot of people can, you know, pay for themselves. But at the end of the day, it's like, you know, do you want to live?
But I mean, even like if you get one with like a significant other or whatever, you could do like a studio if you wanted to. And then then you're right back to like paying this amount, you know, which I got to pay rent. Holy shit.
Yeah.
Oh, yep.
Yeah. I forgot.
Tomorrow you're going to get hit.
Yeah. Forgot about that.
Ain't that some
hey,
shit?
Hey, thanks, podcast. Shout out, podcast, baby.
Yep.
Well, I'm going to go do that. Before I forget. Hey. How long are we at?
Player going to call you in the morning like, hey, sir. Sir,
you guys got any last words?
He's
man?
Like, you got to pay something?
Yeah, this is my last thing. What do you...
I thought you were going to say this is my last podcast. I was like, damn, man.
No. This is my last podcast. They kicked
what,
me
I'm going to shed a tear, bro.
What are we at? What are we at?
We're good. Yeah. Just keep it going.
What are your thoughts on the word durable? what is durable in life? In life, like
what's durable? Wrangler.
Wrangler. Brett Favre.
Yeah. What is the word durable?
The worst
mean
quarterback
to you
in fucking
life?
History. Huh?
What does the word durable
Sorry,
mean
man,
to
you?
You
got me
life?
Pissed off, man. Brett Favre. Jesus.
Hey, so y'all, I can sling it. I can sling a. I can sling
you
it.
Can sling a, you can sling a fuck ton of interceptions. That's what the fuck he can sling.
Yeah, I think he had the record.
Dude, yeah. How, like, don't even compare that motherfucker to. Get the fuck out
but,
of here.
But look, this is the crazy, this is the crazy part. He had the record for touchdowns at one point.
Yo, he probably had like 60 touchdowns and 60 interceptions. They still gave that motherfucker the MVP. I guarantee it. It's just dumb. God.
So he's not durable for you.
Then. No, he's the epitome of not durable. Yes.
So what is for you? What's that mean to you?
Durable. I don't know.
Chuck Norris.
like Yeah, shout out Total Gym, man. He put the motherfuckers on.
He put it on.
Yo, have you ever used a Total Gym?
Hell yeah.
What is it?
Total Gym? You don't know what a Total Gym is?
That's like the thing that like folds down and it's almost like a Bowflex.
Yeah, but like
that was like the first one though.
It's kind of like Bowflex and Pilates had a fucking baby.
Durable.
Yeah.
Durable.
I don't know. I mean, upholding, withstanding. I guess is that a word? Are those even words? I don't know.
Yeah. No, that's what my kind of
resilient.
Yeah, resilient. Very resilient.
I was about to say roll with the punches.
Roll with the punches of life. Like,
yeah, I just feel like
it was something that I always think of. Duct tape.
Yeah.
Duct tape.
I ain't gonna lie. Like, I had one of this do house one time. The half his house was put together with duct tape. Like a door hinge, duct tape.
Oh man!
Did you ever have the duct tape wallet? I remember when that was a big thing back in the day.
Duct tape wallet. Yeah, I remember people would you'd like tape.
Yeah.
Duct tape together so that it didn't stick.
Yeah. Just come to school. Bring the homies some duct tape. Yeah. Then they just make one.
Like my last wallet I had before I got this one, I think I had for like 4 or 5 years, and that boy got raggedy.
Durable.
What's that?
Durable.
You see it?
Baby Yoda.
Huh.
Hold on.
Hey, what's that show called? Mike Lorian?
Mike Lowry. I still can't see what the fuck that is.
Here, I'll pass it to you.
Any other last words?
That's all I got. Oh, that's all I got.
Ron, you got anything? He said durable.
Yeah, that's durable.
What the fuck?
Mm-hmm. Get down, hit. So you go with A, slow down with B.
Yeah. Yeah. Sure. Yo, that phone's like a damn computer in your hand, bro. Right.
Yeah.
Thing's way too big.
We live, baby.
Yeah.
We live, baby.
It's been real, man. It's been going.
Stay hard.
We all
stay hard. Hustle hard and stay tight. Stay hard too.
Stay hard.
Stay hard.
I can't really think of anything clever to say right now, so I'm just gonna
stay hard. Just,
yeah. Hey, shout out!
I'm just gonna.
Sorry,
go.
I gotta shout out Simple Stride.
Simple Stride, yeah, baby. Yes,
shout out Simple Stride. Gotta put it on here.
I gotta give a shout out to Seagram Gin because I drink it and they pay me for it.
Oh, and also 211s. Shout out 211s. Look at you, almost about to waste the milk. Hey, that's why he gonna shit in your bathroom, because you call him.